Another early kick time here in Ames, Iowa, but these fans have come out. Another sold-out crowd at Jack Trice Stadium for this Big 12 opener against Kansas State. And what a day for football here in Ames. I mean, you cannot ask for better weather. 72 degrees, sunny skies, maybe a couple clouds, but this is a bluebird type of day. The head coach for the Wildcats of Kansas State, Bill Snyder, in his 23rd year, his second stint with this program. His numbers are remarkable considering what he took over when he took over this program. And for Iowa State, Paul Rhodes, a local boy in his sixth season, trying to bounce back after last week's loss to North Dakota State. Iowa State won the toss. They deferred, so Kansas State will return to open up this ball game. Morgan Burns is back deep. Burns from 1 yard deep in the end zone will return it. Burns gets across the 20, up the 22, and that's where Kansas State will take over. As far as this Wildcat team is concerned, three things you need to know with them on the ball. Well, they are one of the most efficient teams in the red zone in all of college football since 2011. Their star wide receiver, Tyler Lockett, he's chasing his dad, Kevin's, records for receptions, receiving yards, receiving touchdowns. It is within his grasp. And, well, Coy, they have a certain type of play that we don't see very often.
Yeah, it's a little bit of playground football, Justin, and I love watching. You'll see Jake Waters. He might hand it off. He might keep it. He looks like he's going to keep it. Then he throws it down the field to guys streaking. We'll see how many times they go to that today.
DeMarcus Robinson in the backfield here on first down. And Robinson takes the handoff up the middle. Robinson up across the 30. Picks up 8 yards. Jake Waters, the quarterback, who is actually from Council Bluffs, Iowa, grew up an Iowa State fan, wanted to come to Iowa State, wasn't recruited out of high school, went to junior college. All he did was go to Iowa Western Community College and win a national championship there. His best friend is the running back for Iowa State, and Aaron Wimberly. Second down and two. It's kept by Waters. Waters has the first down up the middle, up to the 39, a 9 yard gain. TJ Mutcherson with the tackle.
You're going to see him give a great fake to the running back, wreaks havoc on the linebackers, gets them out of position. That thing parted like the Red Sea. Jake Waters did a good job. Positive yards there. First down.
You got to expect this Kansas State team will run the ball a lot against Iowa State after what they saw on film last week, what North Dakota State did to the Cyclones.
There's Waters making his check. He sees the looks he likes. This is one thing he did really well last week.
Waters, his first pass of the game is incomplete. Looking for Tyler Lockett. There in the coverage was Sam Richardson. That's Sam E. Richardson. Sam B. Richardson is the quarterback.
Well, Waters saw that he had his corner off position, about a 9 or 10 yard cushion. He liked that matchup out there. A rare drop by Lockett. Waters put it right where it needed to be.
Second down and 10 here for Kansas State. Opening drive of the ball game. The pump fake with time. Going down the sideline to Lockett. Lockett holds it in. Tackled at the 4 by Richardson. A 57-yard completion.
This is a play action to perfection. Watch Jake Waters give a good hard pump fake. Gets the corner to bite. Next thing you know, Tyler Lockett wide open down the sideline. And look at him put it right where it needs to be in stride. Big play for the Wildcats.
57 yards. Waters splits out as the wide receiver. Charles Jones in as the quarterback in the Wildcat formation. First and goal from the 4. Jones gets to the outside. Touchdown. A 4-yard touchdown run for Charles Jones. Already his third rushing touchdown of the season.
They're going to run the Wildcat about 8 to 10 times in a game. Jones was the go-to guy last week. They scored 2 touchdowns off of that formation and play set. They got an early one here in Ames.
Jack Cantelli on for the extra point. A quick 7-0 lead here for the Wildcats of Kansas State. The big play was the 57-yard completion to Tyler Lockett.
You see the pump fake there by Waters, and he had a great double move on the outside by Tyler Lockett to set himself free, separate from the defensive back. Big plays is what you need to do to start off in an opposing team stadium, and then the Wildcat scored twice off of it last week, executed perfectly there. Great blocking by the offensive line. Wildcats got off to the start they were looking for here on the road in Ames.
And conversely for Iowa State, I don't know about you, Coy, but I was wondering, how is this defense that got manhandled last week going to respond? Didn't respond very well on that opening drive. Now can the offense pick up the defense here on their opening drive?
They have to, Justin. They deferred, thinking their defense might have a good shot at stopping that Kansas State offense. The thing that concerns me, last week they played a very physical football team in North Dakota State. Ran a lot of plays against that defense. Well, Kansas State, they're no different. This is a team who runs a lot of plays. They're all about ball control. One of the best in the nation, perennially.
Ian Patterson to kick off here for Kansas State. Devondrick Neely lets it bounce, picks it up at the 3. And he gets tackled at the 11-yard line. Coy, how about 3 things to know about Iowa State when they have the ball?
Well, there are going to be a lot of new faces out there. Jake Campos is coming in for Gannon, who left the team. And, of course, Quentin Bundridge went out with an ACL. Alan Zarr, look for him to take some plays for him. Now, this has to improve. Only 4.4 yards per play last week. They averaged almost 4 per run. The problem was in the pass game. Let's see them stick to the run. When they're going against this Kansas State defense, look out for Jonathan Truman. He's a pit bull out there, playmaker for that defense. He's going to be all over the field today.
A common theme with Kansas State, guys who are walk-ons, now scholarship players and key components. On first down, the handoff is to Wimberly, and Wimberly gets back to the line of scrimmage, sets up second down and 10. This Iowa State team got away from the run last week. Wondering if they try to establish the run here this week.
You see Mangino this week down on the sideline. He said last week when his team faced a bit of adversity, saw that dark cloud hovering over his team, he said he wished he was down there. Had a talk with Coach Rhodes. Coach Rhodes said, absolutely. The more leadership we can get on the sideline, the better.
Second down and 10. Richardson, play action. Has time. Man wide open on the sideline. And it is incomplete. Jarvis West could not get a foot down inbounds.
Had a good opportunity here, guys. You're going to see the scissors route. One guy's going to run the post on you, and then the corner route wide open. The ball sailed just a bit too far. West unable to get that toe in bounds, but they had a big one there. I like what I'm seeing early. They're pushing the ball down the field. Half of their passes last week were behind the line of scrimmage. They're going to take some shots today.
That would have been a 20-yard completion. Instead, it's 3rd and 10, play clock at 2. Richardson buys some time, throws over the middle, incomplete, was behind his true freshman wide receiver, Alan Lazard. So a 3-and-out forced here by the K-State defense.
Well, Richardson was under pressure. You're going to see the defensive end get a nice spin move and force him out of the pocket. He had a great container. Richardson actually did a great job stepping up, trying to make something out of nothing from the beginning. The offensive line for Iowa State, they're on trial right now. They had a rough week last week. There was only 4 men rushing there. They need to improve. They're going to protect Richardson today.
Colin Downing on to punt from his own end zone. Curry Sexton back at his own 35. Sexton, fair catch made at the 42-yard line. A good punt there by the true freshman Downing. 47 yards. 7-0. K-State leads. They get the ball when we come back. Back here at Jack Trice Stadium, a look at today's keys to the game brought to you by Ford, built for tough.
Boy, this is an iconic trap game, Justin. Kansas State is looking at Auburn, the fifth-ranked team in the nation, next on their schedule after a bye week. And also for Iowa State, hey, they started fast last week, up 14-0. They showed ability. They need to do it again, this time sustained.
Here on first down, Jake Waters in the shotgun. Throws over the middle, completes the pass to his tight end, Zach Trujillo. Trujillo with another big gain up to the 25, this time for 32 yards.
Now this is where Kansas State causes huge problems. Watch the tight end here. It looks like a run to the linebackers. He actually fakes like he's gonna run and run block. And next thing you know, Jake Waters is pulling up and tossing the ball over your head. This is that issue that we talked about, that triple option threat that Jake Waters has when they get in that formation.
DeMarcus Robinson now in the backfield here on first and 10 for the 25 of Iowa State. Waters taking the shot to the end zone, and it's incomplete. Flag on the play. Intended receiver was Curry Sexton. The coverage by Kenneth Lynn.
Iowa State was manned up across the board. Mano y mano, Wally Burnham is lining his troops up to stop the run. Well, now you have to win a one-on-one battle.
Number 8 defense, 15-yard penalty, first down.
The referee is Greg Burks, an easy pass interference call.
You can see the corner outside is press, the inside defender on the slot receiver there in off coverage. He was looking at the eyes of the receiver, doing what he's taught to do, but that offhand, you saw it interfere with the receiver on that play. That was Kenneth Lynn. Just remained patient. He was in perfect position.
First and goal from the 10 here for the Wildcats, already up 7-0. Waters changed the play at the line.
At the top.
Waters to the end zone. Through the hands of Tyler Lockett, like you said. What'd you see there? Why?
Well, Wally Burnham again said he was going to test this secondary. Jake Waters saw that they were manned up. And when I'm looking at this field and see Tyler Lockett out there to my right, Jake Waters says, I'm going to give my playmaker a chance. A bit high there, but a great route. I think we'll see this again. They love it down in the red zone. Anytime they get Lockett manned up.
Iowa State's gonna be forced to burn a timeout. Sam E. Richardson had to run on the field late. So Paul Rhodes calls a timeout to make sure his defense is set. Second and goal from the 10 will be coming up here for the Wildcats. There is Wally Burnham, the defensive coordinator for Iowa State. And for Kansas State, this offense, I mean, it really started clicking last year as they finished 6-1. And here are the different looks that we see from them.
Yeah, Justin, you're going to see the big catch here by Lockett. That is not the way Iowa State needed to start this game. They needed to get off the field, but big play after big play early in the game. And a lot of it's because Wally Burnham is trusting his defensive backs to get the job done with one-on-one coverage, but it's Kansas State's receivers and tight ends who have won early.
But as we saw from those highlights, you get the zone read with the quarterback Waters, right? As you said, that unique play where that tight end, the quarterback Waters delays, and then he has a little pass, and that goes for 32 yards. It's really tough to defend. You don't see this offense very often.
And you'll see that same thing also, that pass where they fake the zone read and hit the tight end. You also see him then hit a receiver, too. A lot of different ways they work with that.
Second and goal from the 10. Waters on the slant. That is incomplete. Intended for Deontay Burton. And the coverage by Nigel Tribune, the best cover corner this Iowa State team has.
You're going to see press coverage across the board. Everyone manned up tight down here in the red zone. Receiver did a great job. Deontay Burton of getting inside. That's the first no-no as a defensive back in the red zone. Down close to the goal line. Do not get beat inside. He did. That ball's a little better thrown. It's going to be a touchdown.
Third and goal. Can Iowa State come up with a stop and force a field goal? Waters. Out of the pocket. Waters gets wrapped up at the line of scrimmage. Luke Knott, who's getting the start at linebacker, combines with Mitchell Myers to bring down Waters.
Well, Wally Burnham changed it up this time. He only set a three-man rush. Dropped a lot of guys back into coverage. A lot of double teams happening there on the back end, taking away the most potent threats. Waters trying to buy some time. You have to settle for a field goal here. That's a big stop for Iowa State in the second drive.
A 27-yard attempt here by Jack Cantilli. And it's good. A defensive stop here for Iowa State. They face first and goal for the 10, forced a field goal. It's 10-0 K-State.
Take care of them.
Call Quicken Loans today for a mortgage experience that's engineered to amaze.
Welcome back to Fox Sports 1 College Football, presented by Cree LED Bowl. 10-0, Kansas State leading Iowa State here in the first quarter. Ian Patterson on to kick off here for the Wildcats. A touchdown on the opening drive for K-State, a field goal on the second drive. Ian Patterson to kick off. Devondrick Neely, Jarvis West back deep. Neely from the nine. Neely gets up across the 25. Tackled at the 27. Time for a Lowe's Never Stop Improving game break. Let's go to L.A. and Greg Wolf.
All right, Justin, thanks. Nick Saban says that battle for the number one spot at quarterback remains open. Whoever ultimately wins it should use this man a lot, Amari Cooper. 52-yard touchdown. It is 14-0. The Tide rolling early in the first over Florida Atlantic. Justin, Coy, back to you.
All right, thanks, Greg. I don't know about you, Coy, but when I hear Alabama, I think, oh, Alabama. Little Keith Jackson.
That's right, Roll Tide. Important drive here for Iowa State, but their defense made Kansas State settle for a field goal. They need to get some momentum.
E.J. Bibbs, the tight end, in motion on first down. Richardson gets it to Bibbs. And a beautiful open field tackle by Danzel McDaniel, the junior college transfer that this team is high on.
Well, they're going to try to find some ways to get their big tight end and all Big 12 conference player type caliber player, E.J. Bibbs, the football. That time they motioned him across the formation. But here is a great open field tackle, keeping the eyes up. Good job getting that big tight end on the ground.
Second down and nine. Hand off to Wimberly up the middle, and Wimberly gets tripped up at the 34. Jonathan Truman saves a big play from Aaron Wimberly.
Offensive line opened up a nice hole, a crease for Wimberly. They averaged 3.9 yards per carry on the ground last week. I think Mangino felt he needed to get away from the run once they got down and needed to start attacking through the air, but they need to establish a ground game here today.
On third and two, Bibbs in motion again. Wimberly on the carry, the dive forward. It's really close, but it looks like it's going to be shy. Will Davis there to make the stop. Fourth down coming up.
Third and short, Mangino went back to the same play they had just run. A little bit of a zone play, inside zone, running right behind that leader who's back, Tom Farniok. Kansas State defense did a good job being stout in the trenches. Crowd's not happy that they're not going for it here.
No, but I think you have to punt right now, though. Play clock is down to three. Play clock has expired. This was never reset. And now here comes the whistle and the flag. And it will be a delay of game.
Delay of game, offense, 5-yard penalty, fourth down.
When you're struggling, you can't afford to have these kind of mental mistakes like a delay of game. Quentin Bundridge, who was the team's leading receiver last year, tore his ACL in the first quarter last week against North Dakota State. Hasn't had surgery yet, but he's out for the season. Tough loss for the Cyclones. Downing gets off a low punt, takes a good Cyclone bounce, fielded by Judah Jones, and he gets wrapped up immediately. A 44-yard punt by Colin Downing.
Can't wait to see this one, Justin. This is a big matchup between the Big Ten and the Pac-12. Two differing styles of football. It's going to be an epic battle later today. Marcus Mariota, when he's healthy, look out. He's going to have those Ducks flying high in Eugene. But Michigan State, they're built to combat that type of offense. It's going to be a good one.
Who wins?
You're gonna put me on the spot like that. That's cross country in Autzen Stadium. It is loud. I gotta take the Ducks in that one.
I agree. First and 10 here for Kansas State. On first down, it's Charles Jones with a big run. Jones up the middle. Up to the 43-yard line. Kamari Cottonmoya with a tackle, but not before 18 yards on the ground for Jones.
Well, you're going to see a little bit of a cross action here that takes the linebackers a step out of position and gave him a crease.
A quick handoff once again to Jones. Jones attacks that middle, picks up five, tackled by Drake Furch. Second down and five coming up here for Kansas State. That middle of the defense is a concern for Iowa State and their defensive coordinator, Wally Burnham.
They're attacking it right now. Kansas State, the last drive, didn't run it a single time. They threw it on every down here. They're coming out for the run. Here's the Wildcat again. They like to bring the fullback across the formation. There he goes.
A patient running by Jones. And Jones has another first down. Up to the 42 of Iowa State. A 10-yard run. Drake Furch and Mitchell Myers combined for the tackle.
Watch the patience of Jones on this. You see the fullback come back. They love it. He just waits and hesitates and knows that a crease is going to open up. Boy, the inside guys on that offensive line, B.J. Finney, Little, Stuyvesant, they do a great job of getting their man engaged, and then the fullback coming across, that's trouble.
First and 10, Charles Jones, three carries, 33 yards on this drive. Waters to throw, low throw, looking for Deontay Burton once again. The coverage by Kenneth Lynn.
Jake Waters seeing that the secondary is manned up. No help over the top, no help in the deep middle. He's done an excellent job of spotting that, identifying that, and taking a shot at his receivers out on the edges anytime he's seen it.
You see Jake Waters 2 for 6, the two completions for 57 and 32 yards. DeMarcus Robinson in the backfield. Waters, he'll tuck it and run with it. Waters down the sideline, and he runs out of bounds at the 24-yard line, chased out by Jevin Miller, an 18-yard scamper by Waters.
DJ Finney did a great job. He's your center. Watch him. You're going to see Jake Waters look like he's going to pass. Linebackers don't know whether they should drop, but Finney did a good job of getting up on the linebacker there. Luke Knott freeing Waters up. This is where this guy can really hurt you. Two touchdowns through the air last week, two on the ground as well.
Another first down here for Kansas State, leading 10-0. And we've got a flag. Looks like it's going to be a false start here against the Wildcats.
False start, number 65, offense. 5-yard penalty, first down.
That's the right tackle, Matt Kleinsorge.
That right side with Kleinsorge and Drew Little. Those guys are both former walk-ons. Now they made their first starts of their career last week. They showed out pretty good on tape, though. They actually graded out really well, did a solid job. A little anxious there, trying to get a jump on the defensive end.
It seems like half this K-State team are former walk-ons. First and 15. Robinson on the carry, trying to bounce it outside. Good job coming up to close that gap by Kenneth Lynn. A two-yard run for DeMarcus Robinson.
Well, going back to that scissor action in the backfield, it's tough on those linebackers. Robinson seeing a spot to the outside, thinking maybe get around the corner, but excellent job by the corner. Come flying out of the backfield, Kenneth Lynn, to make a stop in the open field.
Second and 13. Waters drops back. Waters, the pass is complete. Caught by Deontay Burton for 8 yards.
That time, Wally Burnham brought the heat off the edge, something he saw that had success last week. Steve F. Austin sacked Waters last week. Waters did a good job staying alive, buying himself some time, trying to make something happen. Here's a third down. Kansas State, excellent in third down conversions, excellent in the red zone. Iowa State has the fans behind them. Huge opportunity to stop Kansas State here.
Play clock down to 4. A flag is thrown. Another false start.
False start. Number 68, offense. 5-yard penalty, third down.
This is uncharacteristic of a Bill Snyder coach team. They were penalized just 15 yards last week against Stephen F. Austin. 2 false starts on this drive. Backs this one up now to 3rd and 10.
Well, Cyclone Nation's getting behind their team here early. They know the defense made Kansas State settle. Last drive for a field goal. Another opportunity here. They're getting loud in Ames.
3rd and 10. Waters. Incomplete. Looked like it might have been deflected. So the defense comes up with a stop again.
Well, the defense bringing the heat, going hard to get after Waters. He may have even gotten a hand on that pass. As you see, the defender maybe caught a piece of Waters' arms. Once again, that was Kamari Cotton-Moya. But look at that ball. Comes out as if his arm got hit there. But great job by Wally Burnham, bringing the pressure, sticking to his game plan, trusting his defensive backs, who were all manned up again with no help. That time it was Nigel Tribune. The receiver, had it been a good pass, there was nothing.
A 41-yard attempt by Cantelli, and Jack Cantelli is now 2 for 2 in field goal attempts. But Kamari Cotton-Moya and the defense come up with a stop again, force another field goal, but K-State leads 13-0. Welcome back to Fox Sports 1 College Football, presented by Cree LED Bulb. 13-0, K-State leading Iowa State. 3:40 to go here in the first quarter. 9 plays, 51 yards, results in a 41-yard field goal by Jack Cantelli. A good start here for K-State. Ian Patterson on the kickoff again. Devondrick Neely and Jarvis West back to return for the Cyclones. A good kick this time by Patterson. Neely has some trouble, takes it at the 3, and he gets out to the 15-yard line. A beautiful day for football. Hungry yet? I know I am. That looks good. 13-0, K-State. This basically sums it up right here. Look at the total yard discrepancy between Kansas State and Iowa State. But really, if you're K-State and you're Bill Snyder, you have to be upset. You're only up 13-0.
2 huge stops for Iowa State's defense. Holding Kansas State to field goals is a win early in this game for that defense. Now it's up to the offense to get this ball moving.
Richardson, the pass on first down. He completes that pass to Jarvis West. And now a little barking back and forth between some guys, Dondre Daly and Denzel McDaniel. A 6-yard pickup for Jarvis West. They've got to move the ball. They've got to get a first down. Iowa State does on this drive. West in motion. They shovel it off to him. Jarvis West has that first down. As he gets spun across the 35 by Randall Evans. A 15-yard play there to Jarvis West.
Watch how fast this happens. Jarvis West comes flying across the formation. It's actually a shovel pass, a forward pass. Receivers on the outside, and the running back, Devondrick Neely, who was off to the outside here, get a good lead block, give West some running room. He's a playmaker. They need to get him the ball in any way that they can. Again, they're missing their top playmaker in Bundridge. We're going to see different guys get the opportunity to step up and make plays.
First down of the day for the Cyclones. Handoff to Neely, trying to bounce it outside. Neely breaks some tackles. Still on his feet as he gets up to the 45-yard line. A 9-yard run when it looked like it was going to be a loss of a few.
Well, Jonathan Truman came flying out of his linebacker position. You'll see him. Looks like this was going to be a tackle for a loss in the backfield. Here comes Truman. Great read. But Neely, just great effort here, making two guys miss. That's all heart. And so right there, that's what the spark that Iowa State needs to get rolling.
On second and one, it's kept by Richardson. And Richardson has the first down into K-State territory at the 46. Picks up eight, tackled by Ryan Mueller.
Great job on the inside of this line, setting it up. Watch these guys blob, especially Farniak. Again, he's the leader. He's coming back. Look at him move his guys out of the way. But on this play, Richardson decides he wants to keep it. He saw that the linebacker was sucked in onto the dive play. Positive yards. This is great energy from this Iowa State offense.
Hand off to Neely. And Neely gets gang tackled. First one there, Travis Britz. A 2-yard pickup for Neely. Second down and eight coming up.
We're seeing a different aura and energy right now. Just remember last week, some negativity hit this team and they buckled under the pressure, but they're coming out with some fire. They're playing with attitude and energy. You see guys playing after the whistle. They're getting the ball moving.
Second and eight. Richardson to pass over the middle, completes the pass to P.J. Harris. The spot is good enough for a first down. Dylan Schellenberg with the tackle.
P.J. Harris did a great job there. You're going to see them line out here, man-to-man across the board, a little bit of cover four, getting a bump on the receiver, but he did a great job of staying alive. He had a career-high four catches last week. Richardson patient in the pocket, waiting for that window to open up, put it right where it needed to be.
First and 10, Richardson to the end zone to his freshman. Flags come flying, pass interference in the end zone. Morgan Burns on the coverage of Alan Lazard.
Alan interference. Defense, number 33, 15-yard penalty, an automatic first down.
Alan Lazard is a tall target at 6'5", only a true freshman, but Morgan Burns, the defensive back, was beat on the play. He had a bit of a push before Lazard went up to make the grab. You just have to remain calm in that moment. Richardson knows that he was going to put that ball up there for his playmaker. It was either going to be a touchdown or a penalty like we saw there. Burns panicked with the foul.
On first down, Richardson comes to the near sideline and completes the pass to Aaron Wimberly, his running back, who picks up a couple yards. Randall Evans there for the tackle. And there is a player down, a Kansas State player. With 26 seconds to go here in this first quarter. The trainer's already out to tend to the injured player. We can't see who it is right now. It's number 75, Jordan Willis, the starting right defensive end. As he gets help to his feet, good to see him run off under his own power.
Willis. You'll see him up here on the end of the line, but watch Wimberly here. What a great block. This is called a chip block. Right up under the shoulder pad. Caught him off balance. Left tackles love when they know they have their running back in the backfield to chip before they release on the play. Good to see Jordan Willis pop up, get off under his own power. But Iowa State, what a drive for this offense. Sam Richardson looking poised. They have momentum.
Second down and 8. Richardson rolling out, throws the end zone, touchdown! Jarvis West! Touchdown pass from Richardson to Jarvis West in a big-time answer by the offense after their defense made a couple of nice stops. Cole Netton on here for the extra point. Jarvis West, 3 catches on the drive for 38 yards.
How about some play action? Get those linebackers running. Watch the hard play action here, but then here goes Jarvis West across the screen. Richardson puts that ball right where it needed to be. He's here on your screen. Jarvis West sneaks behind the linebacker. Truman did a great job of trying to turn and get on his horse to get up underneath that. But West just too quick out of that slot position. That's tough on a linebacker. Richardson knows that he gave the drive that his offense needed. Excellent precision, getting through his reads, sometimes getting to his third read back in the flat in Wimberly or there, putting the ball right on the money for a big strike in the end zone. This crowd is into it, back into it.
An 85-yard touchdown drive led by Sam Richardson following 2 3-and-outs to open up the ball game. Gets the Cyclone crowd back into it. Charles Jones and Morgan Burns are back deep. And this ball will sail into the end zone for a touchback. For touchback time for a game break, let's go back to L.A. and Greg Wolf.
Justin, thanks. Number 24, Missouri on the road at the Glass Bowl, taking on Toledo, and sophomore quarterback Matty Mock on the run and making something happen. Finds Darius White, 7-yard touchdown. Mizzou leads it 14-7 over Toledo in the first. Back to you.
All right, 13 seconds to go here in this opening quarter in Ames, Iowa. 13-7, Kansas State leads Iowa State. Justin Kutcher alongside Coy Wire here on Fox Sports 1, the Big 12 opener for these teams. Waters on first down, comes near side, completes the pass to Cody Cook, who gets out of bounds. A six-yard pickup, brings up second and 4.
Waters knows that he needs to get his offense under control, get the ball moving, take some of the energy out of this Iowa State offense. Defense.
That'll close out the quarter. Paul Rhodes likes the energy and the answer he's seen from his Iowa State Cyclones. We're through 1 quarter of play, 13-7, Fox Sports 1 College Football, presented by Cree LED Bulb. Opening day of the Big 12 season, Kansas State comes in ranked number 20 against Iowa State. The Wildcats off to a quick start, but a couple of big defensive stops and a great 85-yard drive led to a touchdown for the Cyclones as we go to the second quarter, 13-7. K-State leading Iowa State. Second and 4. Waters, design run, Waters to the sideline, has the first down and run out of bounds by
Nigel Tribune. Picks up 16 yards in the first down.
Kansas State was going to try to catch Iowa State here off guard. You're going to see Gronkowski look like he's going to run block the fullback and then sneaks out of the backfield. Look at Waters, just patient. Do I want to throw it or do I want to run it? They trust this guy to make the right decision with that play call. Big game there for Waters.
They trust him for good reason. Finished the year 6-1. Won last week over Stephen F. Austin 55-16. Waters pressured and Waters goes down. Sacked by Corey Morrissey for a loss of three.
Corey Morrissey is the heartbeat of that defensive line. Watch him coming off the edge here. Gets his lineman upfield, then comes with a wicked spin moves. Hits that elbow in the back of that offensive tackle to propel himself forward. Sack on Jake Waters. He was sacked four times last week. Don't think that these defensive linemen don't know it.
Did you say wicked? I thought you're from like upstate New York or Pennsylvania.
New York.
Second and 13. Waters forced out of the pocket again. Waters chased down again. Robbie Garcia. A loss of two, and Wally Burnham's defense is stepping up.
Wally Burnham was a man with a plan, and he's sticking to it. Everyone manned up across the board. He trusts his defense to get the job done in the one-on-one matchups. They won again there. Burnham's guys are playing on fire right now, and the fans in the stands know it.
Third and 15. Waters lofts one up, and it's incomplete. Great play by Sam Richardson. Knocks it out of the hand of Deontay Burton.
Sam Richardson, an outstanding job by Sam Richardson on this play. Look at him D'd up now. The quarterback scrambling. He can get his hands on that offensive receiver now, but look at the concentration. Punch through the pocket just like you're taught to do as a defensive back. Another huge win for this defense. The momentum has clearly shifted.
Mitch Lochbieler on to punt for the first time today for Kansas State. Jarvis West, Devonjic Neely are back deep. Jarvis West takes it at the 18, up the middle. Jarvis West has some room, makes the cut. Jarvis West gonna go all the way. Touchdown, Iowa State, 82 yards. West with the 82-yard punt return for the touchdown. And now Cole Netton on to give the team the one-point lead. 14-13. You think Paul Rhodes is fired up? The Cyclones have answered the first punch from Kansas State. And they now lead by one.
Another beer?
Sure. Give me a, give me a Red's Apple Ale.
Red's Apple Ale. Crisp like an apple, brewed like an ale.
If you want a textbook middle punt return, you've got it. Check out the blocking on this play. Everyone in position, including Wimberly, the off back there, the off returner. Outstanding cut by Jarvis West on the punter. He didn't stand a chance. A Bernini sculpture of a punt return right there. Executed perfectly. A thing of beauty, Justin.
Cole Netton on to kick off here for Iowa State. Burns takes it at the 9.
And Burns gets thrown across the 25, up the 26. Jarvis West, two touchdowns in his last 2 minutes and 36 seconds. This one, an 82-yard touchdown return on the punt. The first punt return for a touchdown since October 30th of 2010 for Iowa State. What's the most exciting play in football? Is that it right there?
I still have goosebumps, but I'm a former special teams guy, Justin, so I love seeing that phase of the game make an impact on the ball game. Jarvis West there, outstanding, breathing new life, even more life into this Cyclone Nation here today.
That is Jake Waters in Kansas State. How do they respond? With a false start.
You can hear the stadium getting louder. You can feel the energy growing here in the stands. There's not a single person sitting in this stadium right now.
Waters hands off to Robinson up the middle. Robinson picks up six, tackled by Kamari Cotton-Moya.
Wally Burnham switching it up a bit, went zone there. Had his linebackers and defensive backs eyes on the line of scrimmage to read run first on that play. Second and long.
Hand off again to Robinson. Good stop by Luke Knott, just a 3-yard gain. Third and six coming up, and the players are asking this place to get loud again.
There's a lot of confusion for Kansas State right now. As that play clock winds down, they're unsure where to line up. You can see the running back still asking for the play call.
And now a timeout will be called here by Kansas State. About something there along the sidelines. He wanted a false start.
You can see him over here on the far sideline. That's the energy and enthusiasm that Cyclone Nation has come to grow and know and love out of Paul Rhodes. He's one of their own. Last week, when there was a dark cloud forming over that sideline about this time in the game, it's all sunshine right now. A lot of rays of energy and light beaming from over there. There's a lot going on right now.
You know, a lot of people say last year 3-9, they lose to North Dakota State. Is that guy Paul Rhodes on the hot seat? No. Look at this place. It is packed. Sold out again. He's a local guy from Ankeny, about 30 minutes outside of Ames. And I tell you what, they love his passion, and that's exactly why. What he does there, he fights for his players. His team has a 1-point lead, third and six coming up here for the Wildcats. Can the defense come up with another stop?
Paul Rhodes has been the underdog in 14 of his 27 wins here at Iowa State. He saw some changes he needed to make, brought in six new coaches. Big play for the defense here on third down.
Third and six. Gronkowski in the backfield. Waters, the run. Waters gets thrown forward, gonna come up shy of the first down. Drake Furch, who is a teammate of Waters at Iowa Western Community College, makes the stop.
This is that play where Jake Waters has the option to throw it if he wants. He decides he wants to try to get it on the ground. Linebackers for Iowa State were gap sound, taking on the fullback who was leading up the way, Gronkowski, and that offensive lineman pulling. That is a huge stop once again for this Iowa State defense. And look who's standing back for the punt. It's Jarvis West.
Nick Walsh on to punts. Fair catch signaled by Jarvis West makes it at the 25. You're watching Fox Sports 1, college football presented by Cree LED Bulb. 1-point lead for the Cyclones. Welcome back to Fox Sports 1, college football presented by Cree LED Bulb. 14-13, Iowa State leading number 20, Kansas State. All right, so we saw how Iowa State responded. How does K-State's defense respond now? Can they come up with a big stop? Wimberly splits out wide, empty backfield. Richardson designed run up the middle as he slides at the 37, picks up 12 for the first down.
Now here's Mark Mangino at his best. Wide splits by the receivers to start. Then he's going to motion his running back out of the backfield, forcing the linebackers to step out of the box. Parted open for Sam Richardson to take off for a big first down.
Off to Wimberly, and Wimberly nowhere really to go, still pushing that pile though. A great second effort, gets 3 yards. Let's check in for a game break. Here's Greg Wolf in LA.
All right, guys, thanks. Let's go to Lincoln, Nebraska. Driving, but McNeese State from the FCS. Aaron Sam with the interception. They have never beaten a team from a Big Five conference. Aaron Sam, 98 yards for the pick six the other way. This game tied at 14 in the second quarter. Back to you.
A good one going on there, a good one going on here. Second and six, Richardson, pump fake, trying to escape, and he gets dragged down by Jordan Willis. A 1 yard little scramble there by Richardson.
Richardson felt that he didn't want to try to force that. He may have even seen a defensive lineman's hand go up in front of him there. I thought Jarvis West was open on this play. He could have come back to the ball, but it may have been that defensive lineman working on his right guard that got up. Smart heads up play by Richardson to pull it down, trying to get what he can.
Third and five. Richardson pressured, escapes the pressure, makes a move. Now he's going to run. Dives forward. First down. Tremendous effort by Sam Richardson.
He's going to get some pressure coming off his right side, the top of your screen there. You see them working with the TE stunt, the tackle first, then the end coming through. But this is all Richardson on this play. He made one of their best tacklers miss to gain some extra yardage. Richardson now moving the chains for the Cyclones once again on this drive.
Shovel pass to West. Good hands by him. West changes course, and Jarvis West across midfield up to the 48 of K-State gets 5.
They came right Schellenberg back to that same play that worked for them earlier. The little touch shovel pass forward to West as he comes flying across the formation there to your left. A one-handed grab by West. Good blocking on the perimeter. You see there, Mangino said if a receiver's going to play in my offense, he's going to block in the run game. I know that was a shovel pass there, but you saw those receivers, big, tall guys blocking on the edge.
Second and five. Richardson has time. Throws to his running back. Wimberly has another first down to the 38, and a flag is down on the field. Jonathan Truman with a stop, a 10-yard pickup. Let's see what the flag is for.
We may have a face mask there on Truman as he had his hands full with Wimberly coming out of the backfield.
Personal foul, face mask, defense, 15-yard penalty from the end of the run, first down.
Bill Snyder keeping his cool there on the sideline. But Richardson, 8 straight completions after an 0-for-2 start. Here's the face mask by Jonathan Truman, an easy call for the officials.
Stiff arm by Wimberly. that forced that error on the part of Truman. Had him reach it, trying to grab for anything he could get a hold of. This offense is moving.
Devondrick Neely breaks a tackle, spins outside, and Neely will be marked down at the 19, gets four, tackled by Danzel McDaniel.
What a difference the energy in this offense this week. It may have something to do with Mangino being down on the sideline this week, but you see offensive linemen running to the football, hustling back to the line of scrimmage, ready to go, chopping at the bit. They have some momentum and they know it.
Second down and six. Remember, this was a 13-0 ball game. K-State up on top, 14 unanswered here by Iowa State. Play clock at three. Kept by Richardson. And he slides, gets hit hard by McDaniel, whose helmet pops off. The crowd wanted a flag against McDaniel.
McDaniel's a guy who showed up on tape as one of the most physical players on the field in week one. The fans wanted this as Richardson was sliding, having a defenseless runner in a sense. Listen to this. The fans may have a point there. Tough call for the officials.
Third and five. West in motion. Richardson throws, completes the pass to PJ Harris, who gets the first down. A big third down conversion here by the Cyclones.
How about the protection that time? Kansas State was bringing the heat. The defenders were having to be in man-to-man situations, but how about the protection? You see the linebackers coming up in the gaps. Great pickup there by Devondrick Neely to give his quarterback enough time to deliver the strike for the first down.
First and goal now from the 10. Handoff, Neely. Neely hiding behind some blockers, gets free. Neely down to the 3-yard line, a 7-yard run.
What push that time by the Cyclones offensive line on the right side, getting push off the line of scrimmage. You see the drive there. Number 70, Burton, Farniak leading the way, and then the great individual effort by Neely to pick up the yards.
Second and goal from the 3. Neely again. Good job wrapping up by Will Geary, pulling him backwards. He'll pick up a yard. It'll be third and goal from the 2.
Running the zone play there. It's been hitting for him. Mangino said, if something's hitting, I'm going to keep running it until they stop it. Cyclones having success there with the zone, cutting off the backside with chop blocks. Farniak leading the way at the point of attack.
12th play of the drive. Third and goal from the 2. Richardson options out to Neely. Neely dives the pylon. Touchdown.
Can you feel it, Justin? There it is. The outstretched football hits that pylon. They set off the sirens here in the stadium. The crowd's loving it today.
Cole netting on for the extra point. 21 unanswered by the Iowa State Cyclones. Two big third down conversions on the drive. Bill Snyder, Kansas State, kind of in shock as Iowa State leads number 20, K-State, 21-13. Third down conversions took almost 6 minutes off the clock. 21 unanswered now by the Cyclones against Kansas State to lead 21-13. Cole Netton will kick off with Morgan Burns and Charles Jones back deep for Kansas State. Morgan Morgan Burns from the four. Burns gets wrapped up shy of the 15. They're going to mark him down at the 15. Well, we've got a lot of great games coming up here today. Coming up on the Big Ten Network at 3:30 p.m. Eastern, Northern Illinois against Northwestern. Then at 5:30 p.m. Eastern, the big game on Fox. It's number 7 Michigan State against number 3 Oregon. How about later on Fox Sports 1, 7:30 BYU at Texas. And the nightcap is Texas Tech at UTEP. This all continues at 3:30 p.m. Eastern and streaming live on Fox Sports Go. Charles Jones in the Wildcat to open up this drive here for K-State. And a whistle before the play.
Timeout, Iowa State, their second of the half.
Timeout taken here by Iowa State. Saw the Wildcat formation. It looked like this defense was a bit in disarray, so Paul Rhodes wants to keep momentum on his sides. Stops the play, 21-13, Iowa State on top. Here with 4:27 to go in the second quarter, 21-13, Iowa State leading K-State. And look at the difference, the first three drives compared to the last two drives here for Kansas State. And the Wildcat. Jones, his defense was ready for it after the timeout. Darius White makes the tackle after a pickup of 2.
It's a smart call by Paul Rose. Call the timeout with the last Wildcat that he saw. They were in a formation that they had not shown yet. Usually there's two backs in the backfield. I think Rhodes thought, hey, this guy might pass it. I need to get my defense in good position with only 4 minutes to go here in the half.
Second down and 8. Waters under center. Deontay Burton in motion. Handoff. Jones. And Jones gets wrapped up by TJ Mutcherson. A good tackle. A pickup of 3.
Wow, a solid tackle there. Had the running back cut it all the way back. Long developing run play. But the front side was all blocked up. Back followed his fullback, Gronkowski, and then thank you very much, Ascend. Good hit, comes up, makes the stick. Kansas State finds himself in a crucial third down.
0-for-4 on third downs are the Wildcats. Waters changing the play at the line. A flag is thrown, no play. It's going to be a false start again against Kansas State. This is shocking right now for Bill Snyder.
False start. Number 6, offense. 5-yard penalty, third down.
Deontay Burton, the wide receiver, called for the false start.
Well, they had 2 false starts by the offensive line earlier in the game, forcing 2 punts. There on a critical third down, it was the receiver that made the false start error. Waters finds himself in a deep third and long situation. It looks like Wally Burns going to bring the heat again.
Waters lost one, has a man open, hits Curry Sexton. A flag is down around the 21-yard line. Let's see if it's coming back or not. It would be a 42-yard completion. Our referee is Greg Burks.
Pass interference, number 16, offense. Penalty may force half the distance to the goal, third down.
That's against Tyler Lockett.
They didn't even try to hide it on this one, Justin. On our replay, you'll see Tyler Lockett come in and clearly set the pick for his receiver. There was a reason he was so wide open. He even saw him stop, stutter, get his hip into it a little bit. Now Waters behind the sticks. We'll see Burnham here sit back in zone. The defenders keep everything in front of them to rally up for an easy tackle.
Negates a 42-yard pickup. Third and 17. Waters.
Waters just throws it away.
Waters wanted to hit to the right side of the field. The defenders out there on the edge, excellent job sticking with their man, especially when the quarterback started to take off and run. It's what they call plaster. Don't take your eyes off of your target. Excellent job once again by the Cyclone defense, who had their hands full last week, stepping up in a huge way today against the 20th ranked team in the nation.
Nick Walsh to punt from his end zone. Jarvis West backs up to the 43. West makes a move again, gets tripped up nicely as he goes back up to the 47 of Kansas State. Let's find out what's coming up at the halftime. We'll check in with Rob Stone.
Coming up on the AT&T Halftime, we preview Fox's top 10 showdown between Michigan State and Oregon, and tell you why the Spartan D is the right fit to limit the Ducks. How will a challenging week impact Texas versus BYU later, and see how both Bama and Oklahoma shot out to early leads. We'll see you at the break.
All right, so we'll see Rob, Joel Klatt, Dave Wonstad in just a couple of minutes. 2:08 to go here. Iowa State leading 21-13, 21 unanswered points. With Wimberly now in the backfield. Richardson in the shotgun. On first down, Richardson to Wimberly, wide open. And Wimberly gets tackled at the 29 by Dante Barnett with a very nice open field tackle.
Great job by the running back. That play, sitting up, making sure his quarterback's protected first, sees that he has a threat in the A-gap, lineman took care of it, turns around, sits down, gets the hands up, big gain. How about Richardson, though? 10 straight completions. This guy's on fire.
On first down, the reverse, Jarvis West to pass to the end zone. Touchdown, Alan Lazor. Kansas State is in shock right now. Jarvis West, a touchdown, receiving a touchdown on a punt return, and now a touchdown passing. 29 yards to Alan Lazard. Cole Netton on here for the extra point.
Lazard, a top 10 wide receiver recruit coming out of high school, a true freshman. But how about the playmaker of the day? Jarvis West buys himself some time, delivers the rainbow. And then it's Lazard, the true freshman, to catch the pot of gold at the end of it. Boy, Mangino has the crowd rocking now. Kansas State with their heads on the chopping block. They need to make some plays.
Smiles for Paul Rhodes. He didn't see that last week. I mean, Coy, we spoke with the coaching staff. We spoke with the entire staff of this team for Iowa State, and they were all down, so down after last week. This is almost a complete 180 from what we saw last week to this week.
I think you have to give credit to individuals on this team like Jarvis West, like Sam Richardson, the defense stepping up as a whole to give this team the energy and life that it needed.
28 straight points over the last 13 minutes and 37 seconds by Iowa State. Cole Netton on the kickoff again. Morgan Burns from 1 yard deep in the end zone. Burns gets wrapped up at the 16-yard line. 1:30 to go here in this first half. And
Kansas State needs something on offense to happen here. I'm not saying they need points. They just need a first down. They need to move the ball to somehow get some confidence back on their side to enter the third quarter.
Which is what they're usually so good at, controlling the clock, grinding it out, time of possession. But this defense today, Wally Burnham's plan has frustrated Jake Waters. Said he was going to go man up across the board, allow his playmakers to make plays against theirs. And they've delivered for him today.
One first down the last three drives for K-State. The handoff to Charles Jones. And Jones up to the 29, picks up eight. Tackled by Luke Knott and Jevin Miller. Waters lofts one towards the sideline, and Tyler Lockett could not bring it down. Kenneth Lynn there on the coverage.
Kenneth Lynn stepping up in a big way. The junior out of Dallas, Texas, against the most dynamic playmaker for the Kansas State Wildcats. Excellent job timing it up. Jake Waters now forced with a third and three.
Waters slings it to the outside, has his man for the first down. Curry Sexton with the catch. Gets shoved out of bounds, picks up 12, and they needed that first down. And a flag is down on the field on the far sideline.
After the play, unsportsmanlike conduct, number 15, Iowa State, 15-yard penalty, first down.
There had to be something there on the sideline. Little extracurricular activities. The last thing that Paul Richardson Rhodes needs right now is for his team to force errors that are unnecessary. That would be one.
Waters comes near side to Gronkowski, who gets shoved out of bounds at the 41. Luke Knott shoves him out, pickup of eight.
We'll see the end of this play here. Receiver gets knocked out of bounds. And we just had some stuff that was happening off of our screen, but point of emphasis this year, unsportsmanlike conduct.
Waters throws again near sideline to Lockett. Lockett has the first down, picks up nine. This is a good 2-minute drill right here for Kansas State. K-State still has two timeouts remaining. Nigel Tribune just playing off Lockett, allowing a 9-yard completion, moving this ball down, stopping the clock.
Excellent 2-minute offense, excellent execution by Jake Waters on this drive here before the end of the half.
And now a timeout taken by Iowa State. Jake Waters fired up along the sideline. He knows the importance of this drive right now. Get some points on the board. They scored 13 points to start this game, and since, Iowa State has outscored Kansas State 28-0. 44 seconds to go here in the first half. Coming up at the half, we'll get you back out to L.A. Rob Stone, Joel Klatt, Dave Wonstadt. We'll take a look at the top 10 showdown, Michigan State against Oregon tonight in Eugene. Number 2, Alabama. Number 4, Oklahoma, both in action. And, of course, talk about Texas, the challenging week for them. But second down and one coming up here for K-State. Still with two timeouts remaining. Remember, let's go back to early in that first quarter. They had two drives that resulted in field goals. They were, I think it was 171-9 total yards in favor of K-State, but they led just 13-0.
to Jones. Jones has the first down. Jones tackled at the 16. Trent Taylor and Drake Furch combined for the stop. And now a timeout taken here by Kansas State to stop the clock at 38 seconds.
Outstanding effort that time by Charles Jones. He made three guys miss in his effort to get that first down. 38 seconds left, now with one timeout, Kansas State looking to come away with six here. Plenty of time. They're so efficient down here in the red zone. One of the best in the nation last season. They'll score 88% of the time, but of those scores, over half of them are touchdowns.
You look at those yards, and K-State still leads in total yards, but the majority of those came on the first three drives. On those three drives, they had a touchdown to open up, then two field goals. Again, they allowed Iowa State to stay in this game because Iowa State's defense forced field goals as opposed to touchdowns. And you cannot forget about the 82-yard punt return for a touchdown by Jarvis West. 38 seconds to go here in the first half. First and 10 from the 16 of Iowa State.
Iowa State bringing the safety down because they know quarterback likes to run down here in the red zone.
Waters escapes, throws, and it's caught by Lockett at the one. First and goal from the one coming up.
How about the effort of Jake Waters on this play? His pocket was collapsing around him from his right side.
Waters gets the snap off in time. Try for the quarterback sneak, touchdown! The near official put his hands up. The official still talking. Touchdown. Big time answer here by Kansas State to close out the half. And now trailing 28-19. It looks like they're going for two, but let's go back. Did he in fact have a foot down for the catch? Kansas quarterback State. Sneak.
Kansas State deciding that they want to go for two. They're going to go from their left hash here. Watch the running back to sneak out into the flat.
Charles Jones is the running back. The two-point attempt. Sexton in motion, and a timeout taken here by Kansas State.
It's timeout. Timeout of the Kansas State. Their third and final of the half. 30 seconds in length.
You can hear this crowd booing right now. And my question to you, Coy, is on that catch by Tyler Lockett, it was so close. Why didn't the replay official buzz down to look at this?
I think that's a good question because you saw that toe start to come off. I think the referee, the official there is seeing that pie land. I think we need to bring in the guy who knows best, Mike Pereira, the best in the business, to see what he saw on that play.
Mike, what did you see there?
Hey, I'll tell you, I can't believe he didn't stop it because is it a catch? The second his knee touches the pylon, he is considered out of bounds. And so did he have control first before the knee touched the pylon? Did the ball break the plane? Two critical questions that had to be asked here. I think you could turn this into an incomplete pass, but it's beyond me how the replay official didn't stop this to take a look at it. Which comes first? The knee touching the pylon or the ball with control of the receiver, I think it happens at the same time, which makes it incomplete, period.
Yeah, and my question, I realize K-State did a hurry up with a snap. However, as soon as that play is made, I would think the replay official would buzz down and say, give me some time to look at it.
Too close, especially here.
You've got to You got to be aware if you're the replay official. You know they're going to snap it quick. You have got to be aware to stop it immediately. You know it was that critical.
Out of the timeout for the two-point try. Running the option. Waters pitches to Jones. Jones gets the block. Flag is thrown.
That's going to be a holding.
Glenn Gronkowski, the youngest brother of the Gronkowski family. He's going to get called for a hold.
He gets a whole handful of jersey. He had the defender who he assumed.
Holding. Number 48 offense. 10-yard penalty. Reattempt to try.
Well, now you're going to go for an extra point, not for a two-point conversion.
You had Mutchison coming underneath the block. And that's what caught Gronkowski off guard. Grabbed jersey, got him spun around. Easy call there for the official. But now Kansas State's going to have to settle for that extra point.
The replay official is Mike Angelis. Again, this Iowa State crowd not happy. They thought that play should have been reviewed. I'm in agreement. I think it at least should have been reviewed. Whether it's overturned or not, just review it and make sure you get it right. Now the extra point attempt is actually a 30-yard try. He had a field goal earlier from 27 and 41. This is the extra point from 30. Good for Jack Cantelli. So Kansas State behind Jake Waters marches down the field in that two-minute offense, and they put a touchdown on the board. A big, big response by Waters. A kid who grew up wanting to play here at Iowa State. Got his team off to a great start. Now he's trying to fire up the troops again. 26 seconds to go here in this first half. What a first half of football, huh?
You gotta love it. How can you not love this? I mean, back and forth, the ebbs and flows of this game. You have the 20th ranked team in the nation fighting off the wounded animal, Iowa State, who in week one lost their most dynamic playmaker in Quentin Buntridge. They lost their starting center. They lost their starting free safety. But there are still plenty of playmakers here today who are showing up. One of them has been Jarvis West. You see Buntridge there on the sideline. We wondered who would step up in his place. There's been several guys. Jarvis West, Devondre Keneally, another one. How about Wimberly back there to receive the kick now?
Ian Patterson kicking off. Jarvis West from a yard deep will try to return it. West. This time he'll get up to the 10-yard line, and that's where it'll stop. 18 seconds to go here in this first half. Don't forget, we got baseball coming up today here on Fox Sports 1. The Royals at the Yankees. The Royals won last night, 1-0 in the opener of that series. Eight-point lead for Iowa State. Remember, four of the last five meetings between these schools have been decided by a touchdown or less. Last year, well, that was a blowout, 41-7. Sam Richardson, they will just take a knee here to wind out this first half. A fantastic first half of football from here in Ames, Iowa at Jack Trice Stadium. 28-20. Iowa State scored 28 unanswered. K-State with a big touchdown to close out the half. But right now, let's get you out to L.A. Rob Stone, Joe Klatt, Dave Wanstead have the halftime report. Guys, have some fun.
Time ago, but that's old-fashioned.
Good old days. Well, that certainly, things have changed as we start this third quarter. Iowa State with the ball on first down. They hand off. Time now for the Geico first half stats, a pickup of two. Let's take a look at those first half numbers. And you see the pass yards are pretty even. The total yards in favor of Kansas State, but again, that 82-yard punt return by Jarvis West for a touchdown. Time of possession right there. Penalties, though, too many for Kansas State. On second down and eight. They swing it out to Wimberly. A flag on the play. Wimberly gets spun around up to the 30. Let's wait to see what this flag is for. Again, we have been joined here by Coach John Cooper, the Hall of Famer, inducted into the Iowa State Hall of Fame this weekend. Coach, we know you're here to watch this game, so we want to thank you for joining us. Go out there, enjoy it. And we know you can't root while you're on the air, so we'll let you root when you're in the sidelines.
Offside, defense number 7 in the neutral zone, 5-yard penalty, 2nd down.
Thank you very much. Before I leave, let me tell you what a great football coach Bill Snyder is. That guy is an all-time great coach. Will definitely be in the Hall of Fame, no question about it.
No question about it. What he has done with this program is truly remarkable. Coach, thank you. Congratulations.
Thank you very much. Keep up the good work.
Thank you. After the penalty, it's 2nd down and 3. Richardson throws to his tight end, Bibbs, who has the first down. Tackled by Will Davis, tripped up, a completion of 6.
Bibbs that time working one-on-one against the linebacker Will Davis on that play. A pivot route. He started inside, stuck his foot in the ground, and worked back out to the sideline. Richardson putting it on the money. Wanted to get Bibbs active in this offense. An all Big 12 caliber tight end.
1st and 10. West in motion. A handoff up the middle to Wimberly. And Wimberly will get 2 on 1st down. Don't forget, Iowa State won the toss. They elected to defer, so they open up this half with the ball. But also, that's big for them because K-State had that touchdown to close out the first half. So can they get momentum back on their side?
Well, Jake Waters did an outstanding job before the half. He was 5 for 6, 53 yards, marched the Kansas State Wildcats down the field for a much-needed touchdown. Stop some of that momentum for Iowa State.
On 2nd and 8, setting up the screen, deflected, caught by Wimberly anyway. And he has the 1st down up to midfield.
You're going to see the cavalry get out, execute this screen game. All 3 of them in the middle. Look at them set and then drive. Get up the field. Big number 70, Burton there, getting up on the linebacker. Excellent execution. Mangino loves his screens, whether it's to a running back or a wide receiver. Big hit there.
1st and 10 from midfield. Richardson forced out of the pocket. He's going to run with it, and he's going to step out of bounds. Let's see where they mark him down at the 46. Picks up 4, chased out by DeCorey Johnson.
Richardson was facing a cover 3, the 3 deep defenders, 4 underneath. Nowhere to go with the football. Great job getting himself some time. Ends up gaining 4 or 5 yards on 1st down. That's an excellent pickup.
2nd and 6. Handoff. Wimberly. Flag comes flying out. Ryan Mueller with a tackle. Again, our referee is Greg Burks today.
Might be the right tackle on this play that was flagged.
Illegal shift. 2 men moving at the same time. Offense. 5-yard penalty. 2nd down.
Haven't seen many penalties against this Iowa State team so far today.
They've been clean all phases of the game. Defense has stepped up big. Special teams making a huge appearance with the punt return for the touchdown. And the offense, how about Sam Richardson now? This guy is playing lights out at the quarterback position.
2nd and 11. Wimberly, great cut. Cuts it back, and Wimberly gonna come up a yard shy of that 1st down marker. Tackled by Dante Barnett. So shifty is Aaron Wimberly.
How about the double team that you get off the inside there and the tackle widening the hole? Great job by Wimberly getting up the field, falling forward, some extra yards, a 3rd and 1.
Wimberly again, and Wimberly, a far official saying he is short. 4th down coming up. Ryan Mueller, the All-American defensive end, with a big stop. And it looks looks like this Iowa State team's going to go for it on fourth and one. Last week, they could not convert.
That's a big stop by Mueller. Wimberly had an angle there to hit that first. I needed to get to the 40.
Previous play is under further review.
My guess is they're going to look at the spot of this ball. And I'm sure what Iowa State fans are saying is, why wasn't that play at the end of the first half under review?
They need to get to that 40-yard line, but how about Mueller shedding off the tackle? Individual effort was outstanding, but the knee of the runner goes down, and it doesn't look like the ball ever crossed the plane. Again, it looks like it's right there on that 40-yard line, but what an effort by Mueller with an offensive tackle draped all over him, snags up the running back, and crumples him, pulls him back away from the first down marker.
A quick review.
After further review, the ruling on the field is confirmed. Fourth down.
So fourth and one coming up.
Big stop there. Ryan Mueller is one of those guys we talked about earlier here, Justin, a former walk-on, a team captain. After a good ending to that first half, it was needed that the Kansas State defense step up. Iowa State was moving the ball on them well after their first two drives. Almost unstoppable, in fact.
All right, big play here. Opening drive for Iowa State. Fourth and one. They have to get to the 40. Wimberly in the backfield. Wimberly. Where's the spot? Kansas State looks like they have come up with a stuff. Marquell Bryant with a big defensive play for the Wildcats.
Marquell Bryant, you'll see him there circled on your screen, and we're going to roll it and watch him get in the gap. It's EJ Bibbs, the Big 12 conference caliber tight end, going against him. All effort, gets in his gap, knows his responsibility, and roll within that defense on a crucial fourth and one. Kansas State stepping up big to shut down the Cyclones there.
Here on first down for K-State, Waters keeps it. Waters, good spin move up to the 48-yard line. Picks up seven.
Marquell Bryant gave the Wildcats exactly what they needed. They ended the first half well. Jake Waters marched the team down the field, executed extremely efficiently, 5 of 6 completions, gets that hot offense back on the field. And you see Waters again. He looks like he's in his zone.
2nd and 3. Deontay Burton, the player in motion. Hand off to Robinson. And Robinson will get a yard. Drake Furch with the tackle. 3rd and 2 coming up. And Coy, I don't know about you, but to me, this drive right here could be the turning point of the game either way. If Kansas State can march down, score a touchdown, momentum totally on their side. If Iowa State
without question, Justin, and they're going to go with the Wildcat here. This is that formation that Rhodes had to call a timeout earlier.
Charles Jones as the Wildcat. Jones trying to get outside, gets stopped. Kamari Cottonmoya with the push.
Wow, I don't blame the play call. The Wildcat was hitting well for them in week one, but look at this penetration by the defensive line. You had two offensive pullers out there in front, but what an outstanding stop by the Cyclones. They needed that one because Kansas State, you just had a feeling they were on the verge of getting that momentum back.
The punts by Nick Walsh. Jarvis West lets it go over his head into the end zone for a touchback. Just like Kansas State's defense stepped up,
on fourth and one. Iowa State's defense steps up on third and short to force the punt, the third and out for Kansas State.
You see Mangino there last week. He was up in the booth. He said he needed to get down there. He wants to look his guys in the eye. And there's been a marked improvement on the energy and intensity with which this Iowa State Cyclone offense is playing. He may be the difference that we're seeing out there today.
First and 10 from the 20. Richardson completes the pass to Jarvis West. Up to the 27, picks up seven. Randall Evans with the tackle. 13 straight completions for Sam Richardson.
Richardson's a guy who was tasked with learning this new offense. They said he learned it in months.
Quarterback draw. Richardson gets wrapped up, tackled by Jonathan Schruman at the line of scrimmage. So third and three coming up here for Iowa State. Jonathan Schruman, the team's leading returning tackler, preseason all Big 12. One of those walk-on to captain players.
Five tackles last week. That guy's a player, Justin. They need someone to step up on the defensive side of the ball.
Third and three. Richardson trying to run for the first down. He has it. And he slides across the 35 to 36. He saw that opening. He took it.
Richardson saw the blitzer coming off the right side, and he had all three receivers out to his left who were locked up. But then this is the problem. Look at Richardson. He wants to get rid of that ball. Line does a great job of fanning out the pocket. Richardson sees that he has a crease. He takes it to keep the chains moving.
Second time he's run for a first down on third down. Quickly slings it out to West. Jarvis West cuts it back. Jarvis West is having himself a ball game, folks. An 8-yard completion, the run after the catch. What has Jarvis West done today? He has ignited this crowd. Jarvis West on that shovel pass, making people miss, catching a ball for a touchdown. 82-yard punt return for a touchdown. And he threw for a touchdown as well. Devondrick Neely on the handoff. Neely across midfield. Shoved out of bounds at the 44 of K-State.
The offensive line commanding and demanding down there. They have their leader back, Tom Farniak. They are opening up holes in the run game, something they were unable to do consistently last week against North Dakota State.
On first down, over the middle, incomplete, intended for E.J. Bibbs, the unanimous preseason first team all Big 12. And that is the first incomplete pass after 14 in a row for Sam Richardson.
How about Will Davis working against the Big 12 contending tight end Bibbs? Outstanding job out of South Lake, Texas. He's a highly talented linebacker out of one of the nation's top high school programs at Carroll. Great job that time.
Second and 10, Devondrick Neely will get a yard. Third and nine coming up. Richardson had completed 14 in a row. Seneca Wallace had the all-time record for Iowa State at 18 in a row. So he was trying to chase Seneca.
Richardson, highly effective here through the first half. You can see he's in complete control, understands this offense well.
Third and nine. Escapes the pressure, buying some time, and now he's going to go down, sacked for a loss back at the 48-yard line, a loss of five. Ryan Mueller with the sack. That's his first sack of the day after 11 and a half last
Ryan
year.
Mueller, you'll see him coming inside here on a move that
makes the pocket break down enough. You have guys chasing him all over. Effort by Richardson's great, but look at Mueller getting back up off the ground. The guy who wreaked the havoc in the first place ends up coming up with a big sack, getting his defense off the field, putting the ball back into Jake Waters' hands.
Colin Downing to punt. Curry Sexton is back deep. A good high punt. And this will be downed at the 3-yard line. Colin Downing, the true freshman, with a good punt, 45 yards. K-State with the ball deep in their own territory. In this third quarter, number 20, Kansas State trails Iowa State 28-20. They had the ball deep in their own territory, starting at their own 3-yard line. Waters in the shotgun with two fullbacks in. Waters tries to run, spins forward, and he is down at the 5, picks up 2. Jevin Miller and Robbie Garcia combine for the tackle. We saw this Iowa State defense come up big the last drive, stopped them on 3rd and 2. Now you wonder, can they keep Iowa State, can they keep Kansas State where they are right now, deep in their territory, force a punt? DeMarcus Robinson now in at tailback. It's kept by Waters, trying to pass it to the sideline. Completes the pass to Sexton, gets tripped up by Sammy Richardson. Time for a Lowe's Never Stop Improving game break. Let's go back to Greg Wolf.
Justin, thanks. Let's go to Champaign, Illinois. We'll be at Washington next Saturday on Fox. Maybe caught looking ahead. Malik Turner stripped by, how about this name, Wonderful Terry. Goes 95 yards the other way. The Hilltoppers would add a field goal as well. They lead it 27-21. Back to you guys.
Justin Kutcher alongside Wonderful Coy Wire here, 3rd and 6. Pass to Sexton is complete, and Sexton is going to have the first down. A big third down conversion for Kansas State, just their second of the game.
Curry Sexton coming up huge. He's in here on the inside slot. He gets up to the sticks where he needs to go, reads the coverage, breaks it out, knows where he has to get for the sticks. That was vital. Kansas State was 1 of 7 on third downs until that conversion there to keep the chains moving.
Hand off, Robinson. And Robinson gets gang tackled at the line of scrimmage. Jevin Miller, the first one there.
Robinson's a guy who had 11 rushes for 49 yards. He was one of the best running backs coming out of high school in 2010. He got his first career start as a senior last week. Iowa State hemmed him up there.
Under 3 to go here in this third quarter. 2nd and 10. Waters back to pass. Pump fake. He's going to run with it up the middle, dives forward up to the 19-yard line, gets 5. Jevin Miller right there again. Jevin Miller got shifted over from the Will linebacker to the Mike linebacker this week. He's made a difference with him moving over and Luke not coming in.
There's no question he's been a difference maker today. He's in there, he's making the calls. There he was, dropped back in the zone. He saw that the quarterback pulled it down and started to run. Kansas State finds themselves again in a 3rd and 5 situation. They're used to being in 3rd and short, but Iowa State's been winning on 1st and 2nd down today.
On 3rd and 5, Waters will run again, makes a move, dives forward. And that's really close. I think he has the first down. Let's see. First down.
Something they like to do, 3rd and 3, 3rd and 5. They like to do the design quarterback draw. They had great success with it last week on 3rd downs and in the red zone. You'll see it show up as well. They trust Jake Waters to keep the sticks moving.
Back-to-back 3rd down conversions here for Kansas State. Waters goes out. They go the Wildcat with Charles Jones.
Wildcat is something that forced Paul Rhodes' defense to work on this week. They had great success with it last week. Jones had two touchdowns on the ground in the Wildcat formation. You can tell that these players were prepped and ready to rock today to stop that play.
Second down and nine. Play clock down to five. Running the option. Waters pitches it out to Jones. Cuts it back. Jones gets tackled at the 33-yard line. A pickup of eight. Kamari Cotton-Moya with the stop. Another third down coming up here for the Wildcats. They've already converted two on this drive. It's third and one.
Third and one is an excellent situation. Kansas State, one of the best in the nation at converting.
Waters waits patiently. Has the first down. Waters breaks free and gets tripped up. Tripped up by TJ Mutcherson, who just saved a touchdown.
Once again, you're seeing the athleticism of Jake Waters take over. In a crucial situation like a third down, they trust him to take the ball.
The third quarter has come to a close, 28-20. Iowa State leads K-State. Fox Sports 1 College Football presented by Cree LED Bowl. Iowa State, Kansas State. K-State came in ranked number 20 in the country. Iowa State coming off a loss against North Dakota State. The first half, we saw a ton of action, 48 total points. We go to the fourth quarter here, and it's still 28-20. No points scored in that third quarter. Kansas State with the ball at their own 49-yard line. First down, Waters throws to his running back, Robinson, out of the backfield. Robinson slips a tackle and is able to pick up a couple more yards. Gets eight, tackled by Sam E. Richardson.
Robinson slipped out into the flat there. The linebacker missed his man. Didn't see him sneaking out there. Kansas State rolling here in the fourth quarter.
Second down and two. Waters, the pass, incomplete. Knocked out of the hands of Deontay Burton by Nigel Tribune.
Jake Waters here, stuck the ball in the gut of the running back, then pulled it out quickly. You'll see, pulls the linebackers up, creates a window for the slant route by Burton. Defensive back was Nigel Tribune on that play to get a hand in and cause the pass breakup.
Another big third down. Waters to run. Waters shoves forward and gets the first down.
Kansas State started 1 of 7 on third downs. They're now 4 for 4. The last three have been all Jake Waters. Quarterback draw, you'll see it again here. They converted the last two. Why not go back to it again? Again, this is a guy that they trust. Anytime there's a critical situation, third down or red zone, Jake Waters is your go-to guy.
12th play of the drive coming up.
Look for a play action pass here.
Waters drops back. Pressure steps up. And he dives forward up to the 36-yard line. Gets 5 yards. Stopped by Luke Knott, his 6th tackle of the day.
Iowa State was in a zone, They had both deep routes. That was the route that hurt them earlier, the scissors route. Well covered there. Not enough time for Waters to deliver the ball that time. Had to take off and run. Picked up five on first down.
This drive started all the way back at the 3-yard line for K-State. Over 5 minutes. Actually, it's over 7 minutes now on the drive. Flags come flying before the pass. Another false start here against K-State.
False start. Number 19, offense. 5-yard penalty, second down.
Cody Cook, wide receiver, former quarterback, gets called for that false start. Second down and 10 now for the Wildcats. Hand off to Robinson. Robinson stopped in the backfield. Second effort, he'll get back to the line of scrimmage. So third and 10 coming up. Let me ask this question. Is this two down territory? Are you trying to get, you know, a chunk here?
No, I think, Justin, that your defense has come out in the second half, has played well, shut down the Iowa State offense. Plenty of time to give them another chance to get you the ball back if you don't convert on this third and 10.
Almost 8 minutes on this drive. On third and 10, Waters over the middle, completes the pass to his running back, Robinson, who dives forward, and he's going to be just shy of that first down marker. Maybe less than a yard. Jevin Miller and Luke Knott combined for the stop. And now they're going to go hurry up and go for it on fourth.
Watch the quarterback sneak.
Waters. Did he get it? It looks like he got stopped. Paul Rhodes on the sidelines going crazy. A huge stop for the Cyclones on fourth and one. Cyclones ball when we come back. A huge stop by Iowa State on fourth and one. They get the ball back. Paul Rhodes pumping up his defense. Iowa State takes over. Leading by eight. 11:35 to go here in the fourth quarter. On first down, Richardson throws to Jarvis West. And West is down at the 37-yard line, picks up seven. But I want to go back to this drive by Kansas State. 16 plays, 66 yards, 8:29 off the clock, no points. Go back to the first quarter. They had two drives that resulted in field goals, missed opportunities.
Had more penalties show up, too, in that drive, false starts. Getting behind the sticks again. It showed up too often for Kansas State today.
Handoff to Wimberly up the middle. Wimberly going to be real close to that first down marker. And it will be a first down. Jordan Willis with a tackle. Now, at the same time, give a ton of credit to Iowa State's defense.
And they deserve every bit of it. They've played outstanding today. After not being able to stop the North Dakota State run game that they saw last week, they are operating well in the run game. Also, man-to-man across the board in most situations today, they've been winning.
First and 10. Wimberly on the carry again. He'll pick up a couple yards. Jordan Willis with his second straight tackle.
Kansas State needs someone to step up and make a big play. They need the momentum to come back after getting stopped on fourth down. They need some energy in life again, like they had going at the end of the first half.
Second down and eight. Richardson. Pressure out of the pocket. Makes a move, and now he slides. A good play by Sam Richardson, making something happen with his feet. We do have a player down for K-State. That's Jordan Willis. Third and three coming up. Jordan Willis down on the field. We'll check back with him when we come back. Iowa State leads by 8. Iowa State trying to upset number 20 Kansas State. Paul Rhodes and his crew lost last week to North Dakota State out of the FCS, 34-14. Third and three. Richardson on third down, throws to Jarvis West. And West is able to haul it in for the first down. And did he take it away?
They're gonna have to take
Kansas State is saying they took the ball away. Randall Evans saying he ripped it out of Jarvis West's hands.
That's the play that they needed. They needed someone to step up, and who better?
First down, K-State.
That Randall Evans, a preseason All-Big 12 player, he's their nickel. He's Kansas State's career active leader in tackles, but watch him get a hand on the ball, rip it out. Jarvis West was on top of Evans. That's what the officials are seeing, that he was not down.
This play,
he reached in and ripped it out of Jarvis West's hands while West was not on the ground yet. We'll be back to sort it out and take a closer look.
8-point lead for the Cyclones. This play under review. Back here at Jack Trice Stadium in Ames, 28-20, Iowa State leads K-State. Although this play is under review, Randall Evans thinks he's got the fumble recovery. That was the ruling on the field. Let's now bring in Mike Pereira. Mike, you've seen some replays during the break. What's your takeaway from this?
I think he's got an interception is what he has, because even though the receiver had the ball with the knee down, he's going to the ground. So it's the process of the catch. So since he hasn't completed the catch, what you're going to see is the defender strip the ball away as he's going to the ground here and maintain possession. The ball doesn't hit the ground, so I think they stay with the call of an interception on the field. The only thing they could do is put it to catch and down by contact, but because he hasn't completed that process, I don't think they can do that. So if it's me, I stay with
the call. After further review, ruling on the field stands. First down, K-State.
Once again, Mike Pereira knows best. Thanks, Mike.
Got it.
It's awesome having him at our disposal.
He knows his stuff, the best in the business, Mike P. But an outstanding job by Randall Evans, one of the captains, a former walk-on to a 19-game starter. We talked about someone needing to step up, make a play. Randall Evans, 5 tackles last week, a forced fumble, comes up with a huge interception there.
The first turnover of the game for either team. Can the defense pick up the offense here for Iowa State? Waters throws, and there's pass interference against Sammy Richardson. Tyler Lockett, the intended receiver.
Pass interference. Number 4 defense. 15-yard penalty. First down.
Richardson and Lockett have been going against each other, battling all game. That time, Richardson panicked. He didn't need to. You can see there clearly contact. Tyler Lockett trying to make that catch. Kansas State has some momentum now. Big interception. Pass interference called there. Iowa State has to be poised and calm here in this pressure cooker moment with 9 minutes and 11 seconds to go in the game.
The officials still getting together by the far sideline, talking things over. Everybody's happy. We can play some football. Well, not everybody's happy. First and 10.
Jake Waters is seeing man coverage on the outsides.
Waters, the pump fake. Comes back to Lockett. Lockett makes a move, cuts it back, another move. And now he'll run out of bounds. Marked down to 16.
This is all communication and chemistry. This is all that time that these two have spent together. It's a double move. He sees that the defensive back is playing it high. Lockett knows, my guy knows what I'm going to do. I'm going to sit it down. He's going to put it right where I need to go so I can make a play. These guys, the night before a game, they spend hours together during the week after practice, sitting, communicating. What are you going to do if this happens? If that happens, it showed up there.
A 23-yard completion. First and 10 from the 16. Play clock down to 2. Waters throws, caught by Deontay Burton. Inside the 5, down to the 4. Richardson with a tackle.
Sticking with his plan to go man up across the board, trusting his defensive backs. In the first half, it was Iowa State defenders who were winning. Right now, you're seeing the receivers from Kansas State step up, make plays when it matters most.
Wildcat formation, Charles Jones in with Gronkowski as the fullback.
They like to bring the fullback back and run it to the right. This time he stays
Jones
strong.
To the end zone, touchdown! Charles Jones with a second touchdown of the day. And the first points of this second half.
Watch your fullback Gronkowski here lead up on the wheel backer. Charles Jones scored twice last week in the Wildcat formation. Again, stepping up big in a crucial moment here in the fourth quarter.
Down by 2, 8:01 to go. You got to go for 2. Jones the tailback. Waters under center. Lockett in motion. And now a timeout called by Jake Waters.
Timeout, Kansas State. Their first of the half. 30 seconds in length.
First timeout taken by Kansas State. They need this two-point conversion. This is the Wildcat with Charles Jones that leads the touchdown.
Again, this is something that they love in the red zone. They love it on third and short situations. Iowa State, for the most part, had done a good job of stopping it. That time, they made a changeup. Fullback did not come across the formation like they had shown over and over again. That time, they went with a straight lead action there to the left side of their offensive line. That good push and opened the hole for Jones.
We've talked so much about that first quarter where Kansas State had opportunities to put this game away. But big defensive stops by Iowa State forced field goals. This is another big opportunity for Iowa State's defense. Can they come up with a stop on this two-point conversion?
Now's when they need it most. Bill Snyder's team has come out after a poor showing in the first half, and they're looking like the Kansas State that the Wildcat Nation knows and loves.
Waters in a shotgun, Gronkowski as the fullback. Waters to run, Waters, does he get blocked? He does, he gets stuffed. Kamari Cotton-Moya with a big play. And Waters is shaken up on the play. Kamari Cotton-Moya meets him head on. 2-point lead for Iowa State. How big was this play for Iowa State? How about this? They have not beaten a top 25 team
since October 6th of 2012 when they knocked off 15th-ranked TCU. Paul Rhodes' crew leads by two after the huge stop on a two-point conversion try. Ian Patterson to kick off, a high short kick. Wimberly takes it. Wimberly returns it across the 25. This game has been awesome. The game coming up later on Fox, we hope it's just as great. Michigan State, number 7 in the country, travels out to Eugene to take on number 3, Oregon, 5:30 p.m. Eastern on Fox. Gus Johnson, Charles Davis, Molly McGrath with the call on that one. Waters is okay after getting shaken up on the play. So here is Iowa State with the ball, under 8 to go, leading by 2. Richardson taking a shot down the field. Incomplete. What a play by Randall Evans. Knocking it out of the hands of Dondre Daly.
Another outstanding play by Randall Evans. There he is. He's your nickel. He's your team captain. One of your stars on defense. Sam Richardson threw that ball a bit short, but how about the effort of Randall Evans? Talk about not panicking, punching the pocket, knocking that ball loose. He's a playmaker for the Wildcats.
Play action. Richardson completes the pass to Jarvis West for the first down.
Kansas State playing with fire now. They bring in a rusher up, went man-to-man on the guy who's been making plays all day. Jarvis West working there against Schellenberg, the safety. He's quick as a cat in that slot. Picks up a big first down there.
A career-high 8 catches for Jarvis West. He is stepping up with Quentin Bundridge out for the year with a torn ACL. Handoff to Neely. Neely, a good run on first down, tackled by Randall Evans. Picks up 4 yards, second down and 6.
You can see both teams, both squads know how big this moment is. A sense of urgency on both sides of the ball. What a battle back and forth here in the second half as Iowa State looks to upset 20th-ranked Wildcats.
Richardson throws high, going up to get it to the freshman, Alan Lazard, for the first down.
Once again, the Wildcats are bringing the pressure in the do-or-die moment. They got guys coming off the edge, but look at the running back come across. That's Devondrick Neely sticking his face in there, sacrificing a body to protect his quarterback, Richardson. Give him enough time to make the throw to the true freshman, Lazard, out to his right.
First and 10 at midfield. Running the option, the pitch. Neely. And Neely's going to be taken down for a loss of 4. Dylan Schellenberg and Ryan Mueller combined for the tackle for a loss.
What a play by Schellenberg on this. He shuts down not only the quarterback, but also then rallies to the ball. Makes the play, gets stretched out, and then you have Ryan Mueller hustling. That's all this guy knows. All out, all the time effort coming from the opposite side of the field for a big tackle for a loss.
Second down and 14. Aaron Wimberly in a tailback. Play action. Richardson. Richardson trying to get to the far side, gets chased down by DeCorey Johnson. DeCorey Johnson just saved a big game.
How about the effort? It shows up again. First of all, the defensive backs know they need to keep outside leverage with the help Grover underneath. Richardson wants to go, smart to pull it. But look at the effort of DeCorey Johnson getting on his high horse, chasing an athletic Richardson down for a big stop. Now the Cyclones find themselves in a third and long situation.
Third and 13. Iowa State has to get to the 40. It looks like they're going to let the time go down, then call a timeout. And there is a timeout by Paul Rhodes. Under 5 to play here in Ames. 2-point lead for Iowa State over number 20, K-State.
What a day for football here in Ames, Iowa. What a game we've had. 28-26. Iowa State trying to upset number 20 K-State. Justin Kutcher alongside Coy Wire here on Fox Sports 1. Third and 14 coming up here for Iowa State. They have to get to the 40 of Kansas State. Out of the timeout. Richardson, pressure, escapes. Mueller trying to chase him down, still on his feet, gets it away. There was a receiver in the area. That was Aaron Wimberly. What an effort by Sam Richardson to avoid that sack.
But how about the Kansas State defense led by Ryan Mueller? You're going to hear his name all season long. Look at him coming off the left side. He always keeps his motor running. To be able to track down Richardson, who was fighting for his life to stay alive. The defensive secondary had everyone on lockdown. How about the effort this defense coming to life in a crucial moment in this game?
That play by Richardson just saved them 17 yards, which is crucial at this point in the ball game. Colin Downing punts. Curry Sexton makes the catch over at the 18-yard line. 4:40 to play. Don't go anywhere. Two-point game. Number 20, K-State with the ball when we come back. Back here in Ames, Iowa. 28-26. Iowa State leads Kansas State. More great games coming up here on the Fox family. Northern Illinois against Northwestern at 3:30 p.m. Eastern on Big Ten Network. The big game, Michigan State at Oregon on Fox at 5:30 Eastern time. Here on Fox Sports 1, BYU versus Texas at 7:30, and Texas Tech at UTEP at 11 p.m. Eastern. You can watch all those games streaming live on Fox Sports Go. The pass is too high for Gronkowski from Jake Waters. Gronkowski had running room, and Coy, that was the play we talked about at the very top of the show.
Well, they've been hitting with the run, with Jake Waters keeping it, following his fullback up there, leading on the linebackers to block. Next thing you know, he's running down the field. Jake Waters jumps up, pop pass. Iowa State got lucky. That was a bit high. There was a lot of running room had he caught it.
Second and 10. Waters throws towards the sideline. Incomplete for Tyler Lockett. Nigel Tribune, the best cover corner for the Iowa State defense, makes the play.
Nigel Tribune and Tyler Lockett again. Been going at it all day, battling. How about the effort? Looking back at the last moment, seeing that ball, putting out a hand without wrapping his offhand around the receiver. These two warriors all day. Nigel Tribune stepping up big there.
Third and 10. Waters forced out of the pocket. Gets rid of it. Fourth down coming up.
How about the coverage once again? Wally Burnham said, I trust my defensive backs. I'm going man-to-man all day, my guys versus theirs, one-on-one situations. Again, a huge moment. The defense comes up with a win, as they have all day long.
Fourth time today, they've forced a three and out. Nick Walsh to punt. Jarvis West, fair catch, made at the 37-yard line. Iowa State is 4 minutes and 17 seconds away from upsetting number 20 Kansas State. And now, let's not forget about one of the keys. You said, don't look ahead. This is a trap game for Kansas State. They've got Auburn coming up next. Well, guess what? Here they are, trailing by two.
They came out fast. An explosive play, marched down, scored on their first drive. It was almost as if they let out a sigh a bit, maybe started to coast, but then they realized these Cyclones came to play. It's been a battle ever since. The defense for Kansas State has to step up big here.
On first down, Wimberly Wimberly gets stopped after two. And will K-State use timeouts?
We had a Kansas State player's helmet come off. By rule, he has to leave the game for a play. That's Travis Britz. He had three tackles last week, a tackle for a loss. Richardson looking to the sidelines, watching that play clock.
This is a rarity, this game with Iowa State and K-State. You have two teams that actually use the play clock. Most teams in the Big 12, you never even see the play clock.
No doubt about it, Justin. Kansas State going man across the board.
Handoff again, Wimberly. Up to the 46, a yard shy of the first down. Jonathan Truman with the tackle. And now a timeout is taken by Kansas State.
Richardson seeing there was three guys to his right. It's a numbers game. Which way to run the ball? You could see him set the call, run it away from where the safety was coming down. Good pickup there. Find themselves in a third and one with 3 minutes and 16 seconds to go in the fourth quarter.
One timeout remaining now for Kansas State. Paul Rhodes and Iowa State trying for the upset. Justin Cutcher alongside Coy Wire. And Coy, the first half was incredible. A lot of scoring, 48 total points. Here in the second half, we've seen 6 points, but maybe the biggest play of the game was that stop on the two-point conversion by Iowa State.
It absolutely was, but then you have to think about the resolve of Kansas State to not give in. Their head was on the chopping block. They could have given up, but to disregard and count out a Bill Snyder coach team would be to ignore common sense. These guys do not give up or give in ever.
Third and one. Wimberly. Wimberly gets stuffed behind the line of scrimmage. Ryan Mueller, the captain, comes up with a big play and a timeout for Bill Snyder. So 3:08 to go. Ryan Mueller with a huge stop. Kansas State will get the ball back, a chance to march down the field with 3:08.
You'll see Mueller there shooting the gap, beating the offensive tackle, Jake Campos. Remember, he's in starting for a guy who left the program earlier this week. We talked about the defense needing someone to step up and make a play. It's been two of their captains, Randall Evans out of the secondary and big Ryan Mueller off the edge.
3:08 to go here in this ball game. Time now for a Lowe's Never Stop Improving game break. Let's check in with Greg Wolf in LA.
All right, thanks. Let's go to Lincoln, Nebraska, and McNeese State tie game, just 32 seconds to go. And Amir Abdullah, look at him break tackles left and right, and somehow breaks free. 58-yard touchdown. Nebraska on top, 31-24, late fourth quarter. Guys, back to you.
So there's some close ones around college football here this afternoon. Colin Downing will punt. Down back at his own 10 is Curry Sexton. Downing. Gets off a good punt, fair catch made at the 20 with 3:01 to go here. Jake Waters, the kid from nearby Council Bluffs, Iowa, will come out to lead his team. And what has he done so far today? Got his team off to a great start.
Well, he's been effective on the ground, but also through the air. Again, this is a unique system. It takes a special player, a special quarterback to run this system that is so difficult to stop. It hits you in so many different ways that you're not used to seeing in conference play. Jake Waters has been the man today for Kansas State, and the ball is in his hands right now. Kicker has a long of 44 yards. They need to get this ball to the opposite 37-yard line about to get within his range.
No timeouts remaining. 3:01 to go. Trailing by two. Looking to run, has a hole, gets upended, by T.J. Mutcherson, but not before a 15-yard run by Jake Waters.
This is what this guy does so well. This is the play we talked about, following the fullback Gronkowski. Like to hit it up inside, but a smart runner sees the edge, patient, takes it, hits it. Big gain there.
On first and 10, the pass incomplete. Thrown behind his intended receiver, Tyler Lockett. Today's game is being produced by Fran Morrison, directed by Scott Katz. The technical producer is Joe Stevens. The technical director is Joe Abenda. The associate director is Bentley Elliott, and our broadcast associate, Alyssa Green. Our stats, Ed Spida, and our spotter, Ken Trevor.
Well, we've had a good one today, haven't we?
Oh, this has been awesome. Waters lofting one to the sideline. Lockett goes up. Makes the catch at the 42 of K-State. Excuse me, of Iowa State.
How about this play? Tyler Lockett, once again, the go-to guy. They go to him two plays in a row. Look at the concentration. Get that toe down. Jake Waters standing tall in the pocket, checks to see the safeties. We're in single high, knows immediately he wants to go to his go-to guy, the big playmaker, Tyler Lockett.
This play is going to be reviewed with 2:24 to go. Remember, it was Tyler Lockett who made that catch at the pylon or right by the one-yard line, his first back before the first half ended. Now this play is under review. That play did not get reviewed.
To me, first of all, note the concentration of Tyler Lockett to get that ball with a defensive back right in his face. It looked like the toe did in fact come in bounds. The only question is, did he have control? The defensive back had a hand in there. Did he have complete control of the ball before going out of bounds?
Let's bring in Mike Pereira once again. Mike, they're reviewing this play. What do you see on this? What are they looking at? Tyler Lockett again. Is it a catch? Did he have possession? Was the foot down? We're trying to get in touch with Mike Pereira right now. All right, there we have it. The ruling on the field is confirmed. A catch for Tyler Lockett. The K-State fans, they're happy. We saw Tyler Lockett trying to massage his legs, get rid of those cramps.
But Justin, big-time players make big-time plays in big-time games. Tyler Lockett's one of the most explosive playmakers in all of college football. This coming down to a field goal. Jack Cantelli has a long of 44 yards. He was fourth in the Big 12, making 84% of his field goals. They need to get about 10 more yards to get in range.
First and 10. Waters has room to run. Waters! Inside the 20, leading K-State down the field again. T.J. Mutcherson with a tackle, a pickup of 25.
Now this is something that Kansas State does so well. They make it look like a pass, but it's a designed run all the time. And how about Charles Jones with the block down the field to free Waters up to push the ball even further into field goal range? They're within it now. What a game we have.
And now you've got to be careful if you're K-State not to score too soon. Hand off. Jones. And Jones is down at the 11. Jack Cantelli getting that right leg loose. He's hit from 27. He's hit from 41 so far today. His career long, 44. Well within his range. Iowa State takes the timeout. I would be very surprised if we see Kansas State throw the ball here on out. Run the ball, no. Keep the ball on the ground, take more time off the clock, force Iowa State to burn their last timeout.
You're gonna see a heavy dose of Jake Waters. I expect a quarterback draw. They may even bring in their running back, Charles Jones, is a very safe Wildcat formation, has had great success with them. They love it down here in the red zone. but I expect to see a heavy dose of keeping it on the ground, looking for them, though, to run it to the right, try to center the ball up so it's not a bad angle for their kicker, Jack Cantelli.
But again, I'm going to ask this question. You've seen it in the NFL. I think back to the Super Bowl with the Patriots and the Giants. The Patriots wanted to let Ahmad Bradshaw score the touchdown so they would get the ball back. Do you, if you're Iowa State right now, if they're running it, let him run it in so you get the ball back now with time on the clock?
Well, if there's one thing that's certain, is the kickers in the college game, you never know what you're going to get. I think they got to shut them down here, force the field goal attempt.
Second and four. Waters again, the run. Waters gets stopped by Luke Knott.
Just as suspected, there it was. Jake Waters keeping it on the ground. Wouldn't be surprised to see the exact same thing again.
A timeout taken by Iowa State, the final timeout for the Cyclones. Again, four of the last five meetings between these teams have been decided by a touchdown or less. In 2009, it was 24-23 K-State. 2010, 27-20. 2011, 30-23. 2012, 27-21, all wins by the Wildcats. They led 13-0. Iowa State stormed all the way back, went up 28-13, a touchdown by K-State before the end of the first half, a touchdown here in the quarter, but they failed on a two-point conversion, and now here are the Wildcats marching down the field with 1:34 to go, both teams now out of timeouts. And Kansas State trying to come back and escape Jack Trice Stadium with a victory.
How about Jack Cantelli, though, the junior from Wichita, Kansas? The thoughts going through his mind right now. This is guy, his older brother, Anthony, was a kicker here from 2010 to 2012. Last week, Jack was 2-for-3 on field goals. But this moment right now on the road, you know that your team is ranked 20th in the nation. And the ball is going to be on your foot to determine whether or not you walk out of here with a close victory in Ames, Iowa.
Third and one. Waters to the end zone, touchdown! Jake Waters puts Kansas State back on top with a minute and 30 to go.
Three plays in a row, they go to their go-to play that features their go-to guy in this game. Crucial third downs here with a minute 30 left. They go right back to the quarterback draw with Jake Waters. Sam Richardson has played an excellent game. The battle with him and Jake Waters back and forth all game long.
Now going for 2 points to make it a 6-point game. Waters, the signal, he does not get in. So it's a 4-point game. Again, a minute and 30 seconds remaining. There is still time for Iowa State to come back.
What a way to end this drive. They go back to their quarterback draw, led by Gronkowski, the fullback, being patient, seals off the linebacker. But the patience of Jake Waters all game with that play, it's really hurt the Cyclones. They haven't had an answer for it. Kansas State kept going back to the well in the most crucial moment of the ball game. They win in that chess match.
Two big-time two-minute drills by Jake Waters. One at the end of the first half, now one here. They started at the 3:01 mark of the fourth quarter. They scored a touchdown with a minute 30 to go. It took just 1:31 off the clock, which means a minute and 30 left. But in basketball, we talk so often how it could be a game of runs. It's been a game of runs here in a football game. K-State opened 13-0. Iowa State answered with 28 unanswered. Then K-State has responded with 19 straight points. But now, Ian Patterson will kick off. Jarvis West is deep with Aaron Wimberly. Can they get a return? This takes a great bounce for Kansas State, goes into the end zone. It'll be a touchback. If that goes out of bounds, all of a sudden you get the ball 10 yards further.
Yeah, they got a fortunate bounce there. Sam Richardson, we're going to get a heavy dose of him coming out. And he talked about the playmakers. They missed Quentin Bundridge, one of the Big 12's best wide receivers. Lost him last week to a torn ACL. Was anyone going to step up? Well, they have. Jarvis West has stepped up. Alan Lazard, the true freshman, has stepped up. Who's going to be the go-to guy now with a minute 30 seconds left in the fourth quarter?
No timeouts remaining. Richardson completes the pass to his freshman, Alan Lazard. They got to get things going quickly. Jonathan Truman on the tackle.
Zero timeouts. They need to be on that ball in a hurry.
Richardson to the sideline. Incomplete, knocked away by Danzel McDaniel. Dondre Daly, the intended receiver.
Well, Sam Richardson saw the corner sitting down to acknowledge the flat route that was in front of him. He zinged that ball out there. Receiver unable to hang on.
Third and five. Richardson swings it out. Incomplete to Jarvis West. You got to go for it here. So this is the ball game right now. Let his receiver too much. Waters, the kid who wanted to play at Iowa State, scores the go-ahead touchdown, hoping his defense can step up and he can get a win in front of 30 friends and family here at Jack Trice Stadium. Fourth and five. Richardson throws, completes for the first down. Gets it to Aaron Wimberly.
Clock will stop on the first down. Kansas State was in a cover two. Player sitting in the zone. They're going to spike it here.
Stop the clock with 54 seconds. Mark Mangino down on the sidelines. Last week he was up in the box and I didn't like it. I couldn't see what my players were thinking. I couldn't look in their eyes, so I wanted to move back down. This is who I am. I need to be on the field. His team has played great today. The question is, do they have one last drive in them? Second and 10. Richardson over the middle, completes to Bibbs. Another first down. Up to the 44 of Kansas State. They're going to spike the ball again. Stop the clock with 46, an 18-yard completion.
Well, Bibbs, the big tight end. Watch him work the defensive back. He's going to jab outside, then come underneath. The defensive back needed to maintain his inside leverage. Bibbs knew it. He was not going to be denied the easy throw in passing lane for Richardson.
Richardson towards the sideline again to Bibbs, who gets out of bounds. Truman drives him out, picks up five. Remember, a field goal does nothing. They need a touchdown to win this game. Bill Snyder pacing back and forth on the K-State sidelines. Third and five. Richardson to West, who can't hang on to it. Would have been a first down. Instead, it's fourth down again.
West was working in the slot. This was a catchable ball. That's something West is not going to sleep well tonight if this game doesn't end in favor of Iowa State.
And he's played such a good game. A touchdown on a punt return, a touchdown catching, a touchdown throwing. Fourth and five. Blitz coming off the edge, picked up by Wimberly. Richardson, can he get rid of it? On the going to do it. Kansas State will come into Ames, come all the way back, and escape with a victory.
Check out the corner cat. The safety was over the top. He comes down. It fooled Richardson. Richardson knew that the only shot he had was to hit that open man before the safety got over to cover that wide receiver. But the safety does an outstanding job getting to where he needs to be in a crucial moment. The gamble paid off there by sending the corner in a blitz in a crucial moment.
Victory formation for Kansas State. Wow, what a game. Heartbreak for Iowa State. A sigh of relief for Kansas State. 32-28. Mutual respect with those two coaches, Paul Rhodes and Bill Snyder, as K-State will move to 2-0 and Iowa State falls to 0-2. Your Academy Sports and Outdoors Right Stuff Player of the Game, the local boy, Jake Waters, the quarterback for K-State.
All game, he has been the guy that has kept this offense moving. He was persistent. He didn't get frustrated. He didn't try to force things when they weren't going his way. But when the crucial moments of the game came down to it at the end on third and short, on third and five, down in the red zone with a touchdown needed, it was Jake Waters that they trusted, that they leaned on. The guy's a winner.
They finished last year 6-1. They start this year 2-0. Our final score, 32-28. K-State defeats Iowa State. For Core Wire, I'm Justin Kutcher. We'll throw back to Rob Stone in L.A. after the break.